a trainer, as a youth worker in different in Portugal and outside also. It's basically that at the moment. Thank you for this sharing. I also was asked to tell a little bit the story of how we got here. Maybe you heard this long-time briefing on the call for the application. This is Japanjiti, and Sue will help me. The Japanjiti, what it means, the word, the concept?
It's a Serbo-Croatian word, and it's basically this to be astonished and like to surprise, or like this moment, like
when you learn something or when you see something that's. Like,
so that moment that you make the click, tack, that you get something. This Sapanjiti started with a group of friends, it was Sue and Mariana at that time, that developed in 2008, started to think about it, and in 2009 we had the first training course. I was lucky to be, to have the opportunity to be invited with them to be in this training course. We did it in February, so already more than 1 year ago, 1.5 years ago, and it was really getting to the concept of thinking out of the box, putting people to think and reflect how we can be a little bit different. And how can we think a little bit out of this box, start to be a change that we want to see, get really our motivations and the way we see the world outside. It was a very interesting experience. We had a very interesting group of people there, and more people got inside of this concept of the Japanjiti. So Japanjiti is not an organization, we call it more a concept. A group of people that have this idea developed, and it's creating these spaces of peer learning, of reflection. Then later on, Costas also joined the board, and other people, we're going to have a lot of meetings along this, and then this year still, we had a second moment in March in Romania, close to Brasov, amazing mountains, amazing place, also, where we did a training course, Seed of Change. So it was somehow a next step. So for the first time it was more as a reflection. In that moment we started to think, how do we develop, engage people to become multipliers, to become agents of change. What can be the skills, what can be the attitudes that they can need to be able to work with others and to engage more. And it was also a nice, interesting reflection, a lot of results for us to take, both inside of the process and both after, in terms of people going back and developing things. And now we are here for another moment. So all the training courses have been different. Totally a lot different than this one also, but just to give you a little bit the historical perspective of how we are reaching. Later on we'll still go for the concrete objectives of this training course that have been changing and like fine-tuning along the way, let's say, and to the program. If you have questions about some GT, about how we get it here, I think we'll have, but along the way, along this, we have still 6 days to be together and to talk a lot about things. Just one thing I would like to also to highlight, probably already noticed, who is the team around, but just to, so we have as trainers, we have Costas, Sue and me, and we have a very special person, Tevi, that is helping also in the training, but she has a special role here, she was a project coordinator, so the one in touch with all of you and with us also, trying to make sure that we had also this safe environment, this nice place to work. She will be taking care of the finances, so she's the bridge also with Kodokan, our hosting organization here. We have Kaya that will be arriving on the 24th, in 2 days. That is, she works for Kodokan also and is supporting Tevi in this work. So, and then also more information about Kodokan, and she will bring.